Scratch your back, you scratch my back. You know, we always do that. But that's hypocrisy. You know, that's hypocrisy. Let us go to the book. Chapter 3. Verse 42. I'm reading to you. To those of us learning Hebrew, it'll be more interesting. Sounds something like Hebrew. وَيِسْفَالَ تِلْمَلَيْكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ. So behold, the angel said, O Mary, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَحَّرَكِ وَاصْطَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. That God Almighty has chosen thee and purified thee, chosen thee above the women of all nations. And I'm boasting that such an honor is not to be found given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, even in the Christian Bible. Mary, the mother of Jesus, according to the Holy Quran, Muhammad makes us to accept that she was a lady chosen above the women of all nations. Ya Maryam, kunti li rabbiki wasjudi warkai raqiin. Say, O Mary, worship thy Lord devoutly. Prostrate thyself and bow down in prayer with those who bow down. ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْكَ. That this is part of the tidings of the things unseen which we reveal unto thee, O Apostle, by inspiration. Muhammad, we are giving this to you by inspiration. Because Muhammad was an illiterate man. He didn't know how to read or write. He couldn't cite his own name. A man with that qualification couldn't have thought about an encyclopedia like this. That today 1,000,000,000 people, they live by it and they prefer to die by it. There must be something in it. There is a chapter in this book, the whole chapter. The name of the chapter is Surah Maryam, meaning chapter Mary, in honor of the name of the mother of Jesus Christ. I'm asking the Roman Catholics, this is the Roman Catholic Bible, sir. They do a worship. I said, look, in your 73 books of the Roman Catholics, you haven't got one called Maryam, Mary, have you? He says, no, we've got Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and Peter, and Paul, but there is no Mary. There's no Mary. So here, in my book, there is a chapter called Surah Maryam. The verses continue. Verse 45. It's telling us about the status of Jesus. So, وَيَسْقَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ. Again, behold, the angel said, O Mary, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ. That Allah gives you glad tidings, good news of a word from Him. اسمه المسيح. His name will be the Messiah. Isa ibn Maryam, Jesus the son of Mary. وَجِيهًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Held in honor in this world and in the hereafter. وَمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. And the company of those nearest to God. Jesus. In the company of those nearest to God. Not physically, not geographically, but in status. Because God is not physical. He's not sitting on a physical throne somewhere with Jesus Christ on his right hand side, on a little stool. Not like an atom. Can you imagine God Almighty, who permeates the whole universe on his throne, and little Jesus, 6 foot Jesus, in comparison, is not even an atom. So no, in status, he's in the company of those nearest to God. Where you come to Nasa, and he will speak to the people, in Mahdi wa Kahlan, in childhood and in maturity. وَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And he shall be of the company of the righteous. When this good news is given to Mary about the birth of the Holy Son, she says, قَالَتْ رَبِّ أَنَّ يَكُونُ لِي وَلَدٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. She says, oh my Lord, how shall I have a son with no man has touched me, physically, sexually? In answer to that, the angel says, قَالَتْ كَذَلِكِ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Even so, Allah creates what He wills. وَإِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا. Whenever He decrees a matter, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. He merely says to it, be and it is. God to create a Jesus without a human father, just that. This is what the Quran testifies. And 1,000,000,000 Muslims without any type of proof from the Christians will believe in the miraculous birth of Jesus. On the authority of this book, you can't brush it aside. No sensible man will brush it aside. So if this book is taking us so far, so close, if there is a parting of the way, you owe it to yourself to find out why the parting of the way is. If you can go so far, why difference now? So we have to come and talk, we must have a dialogue. There is no other way. You can't say, I believe. You are sincere.
My Hindu cousins are sincere. The Jehovah's Witnesses are sincere. The Roman Catholics are sincere. Look, I'm not doubting anybody's sincerity, and I'm sure you're not doubting ours. We are not doubting anybody's sincerity, but we can be sincerely wrong. The Roman Catholics, your Apostles' Creed, sir, when you talk about the Holy Catholic Church, they say it's weak. And 800 million Catholics, they believe sincerely. They're speaking about them. They are sincere. The Jehovah's Witnesses, I say, they are sincere. I say, you are sincere. Can you doubt my sincerity? So sincerity is not the standard. You can't judge truth by sincerity. You have to reason. God has given us reason. We must come, let us reason together. And this is what the Muslim is trying to do. When he does that, people get offended. Because we say, you see, Jesus Christ mentioned nowhere, nowhere by God, nowhere. There is not a single Bible on earth in which he says, I am God, when he says worship. Believe me, there isn't any such thing anywhere in any Bible on earth. You just bring in any Bible, in any language, out of the 2,000 that you have so far printed, where Jesus says, I'm God, or where he says, worship me, I, as a Muslim, I'm prepared to accept him as God, I'm prepared to worship him. I won't speak for the other of my brother. They made up their own minds. But I am prepared to put my neck on the guillotine as you show me in your Bible, in Afrikaans, in Zulu, and whatever language where Jesus says, I am God, where he says, worship me. I am prepared to accept him as God. I am prepared to worship him. There isn't. By God, there isn't. You have the Bibles with you. I have seen quite a few under your arms. It's your duty, even after I am born. We have your department of theology. He said, look man, this Muslim fellow here, he came and threw a cat among the pigeons. He says, now look, let's find this and we will call him, my God, I will come. Special, I'll come. He said, look, we have found it. In our Bible, in some old archives. He says, come, I'll show it to you. I'll run. Show me and I will come. Whatever church you want me to follow, I'm prepared to follow. There is it. On the contrary, this mighty messenger of God, he is going out of his way to tell you that he is not God. He is telling you, he said, I can of my own self do nothing. Of my own self I can do nothing. As I hear, I judge. And my judgment is righteous because I seek not my own will, but the will of him that sent me. That's his greatness. He is on the vibration of God. Whatever God tells him to do, you say, he says. He said, the word you hear are not mine. But the Father that sent me, he had given me a commandment, what I should say and what I should speak, even as the Father had said to me, so I speak. He's not blaming anything for himself. He says, my Father is greater than I. He says, my Father is greater than all. He said, all power is given unto me, it's not mine. Believe, my dear brothers and sisters, I'm reading this holy book. You see, I believe in the hereafter. I believe that there will be a time I'll have to confront, I'll stand before my Lord. And he will ask me, did you read the Bible? I said, yes. He said, with blinkers on. I said, my Lord, I tried my very best to be as honest, as impartial as possible to see in this book where the claims that my Christian brethren have been making, whether they are there. And I find, no, they are not there. Now we have to reason. He said, look, you are not reading this properly. You haven't read this. You haven't seen this. Show me. Where have I gone off in not understanding the Holy Bible? Where? That we are just want to be different. We just want to have a confrontation. For what? We Muslims in South Africa are less than 2% of the South African population. And we are the weakest of the weak. Less than 2% of the South African population Muslims. And we want to have a confrontation with an ocean of Christianity. The white man generally is Christian. Ocean. The African is Christian. The colored is Christian. And now the Indians are also getting Christianized. And among them all, I want to be different. No, I don't want to be different. I want to find